Hey, what's going on? Muriel from the Sunshine Family, and three tips on how to survive rainy season in Costa Rica when you are a Costa Rica expat or when you're just living here in Costa Rica. I don't know how you call yourself when you live here. Some people don't like the word expat, but anyways, this is all about living in Costa Rica in rainy season and some major tips that I can share with you. Well, if you never met me before, how do I know? Why do I share stuff about Costa Rica? Well, I moved to Costa Rica from the Netherlands in 2018 with my husband, Dirk, and two kids. And in the 3 years we are here so far, we have learned so much. We made a lot of mistakes, but also we learned things that I believe others can benefit from. And since a lot of people start to ask me questions about how did I do XYZ, I just decided, you know what? Let's just create a YouTube channel and let's share everything I have learned so others can benefit from my process. So here am I talking about rainy season in Costa Rica and three things that I didn't know when I just came here. Why not just let's dive right in and keep this video super short today because I'm actually a little bit in a hurry. I need to get to my Muay Thai class and I have Spanish class right after and I have to prep some stuff for that. Yes, I have Spanish classes and I will tell you more about that really, really soon. So tip number one to survive a rainy season in Costa Rica is when you live here, you need a dryer. You need a dryer after doing laundry. I always thought, and this is what I did in the Netherlands, also just better for the environment, don't use so much energy, just hang up that laundry or have someone doing it for me, hang it up in the sun and it will dry. Well, I assure you, in rainy season, the humidity is so high, especially in the area where I live, in the area Santa Teresa, in Punta Arenas, Peninsula de Nicoya, things don't dry. If you hang up your laundry, especially in Santa Teresa, I figured it out when we were vacationing there in August. It's rainy season, but it also has a lot of dry periods, but our laundry didn't dry. So I was doing my laundry myself. There was a washing machine, but I had to hang it up. And then the host told me, you better bring your laundry to the laundry service and they have a dryer. So now I live in Costa Rica. I assure you, a dryer makes life way easier because then at least you have dry stuff, because nothing will be really, really dry when it's October, November, when there's this heavy rains that we have in this area. By the way, at the Caribbean side, it is the driest part. Hi, Joey, what do you have? So Joey just came to say hi. I don't know if you saw my video of yesterday where he brought me a piece of a tree that distracted me at the end. But anyways, a dryer, tip number one. Tip number two is, although you don't need an air conditioning because your house is really breathing, like our house, we have an old Tico house which is open at the at the top, so we always have a breeze. We have a breeze on the land, but I assure you, having an air conditioning in the places where you sleep, in the rooms where you sleep, keeps your bed dry. And it sounds weird, as if your bed is wet. No, it's not really wet, but in rainy season, it feels just humid, right? It feels like sticky. And since we bought an air conditioning for the area, for the room where the bus, it's actually a bus where we sleep, and our son also has a bus, we placed two air conditionings there, not to use them that it's cooler in temperature, but to suck up the humidity. So actually we use the setting dry, so it actually dries up the air, and that way you keep the mold away using an air conditioning to prevent mold and to prevent everything feeling sticky and humid. So that's a big tip. I didn't know that. I was always like, you know, an air conditioning, we're just gonna create a house or have a house that we don't need that. I don't want to rely on air conditionings. I live in a tropical country, but I assure you, it keeps everything drier and keeps the black mold away. And the black mold is super, super bad for your health. And it happens in humid areas, such as in Costa Rica in rainy season. So this is a big, big tip to just consider to have an air conditioning and to use it to prevent all that stuff. Tip number three, is, and that's a tip overall, when it's rainy season, and especially in the more remote areas, that is where I live, but there are so many areas where the roads are not in bad shape. In rainy season, it will be worse because big rain floods will flood over the roads. The rain will just find its way to the side to just get off the road. And that creates like little rivers, and that can become deep holes, deep ditches. And you cannot just cross that on high speed. It's super dangerous. Also because of the rainwater is in those holes, often you cannot see how deep those holes are. And I have seen cars getting in a hole so deep, just were stuck with their wheels and couldn't get out, and the bottom part of the cars just broke. So these ditches or holes can be so deep. So don't, this is my biggest tip, number three, don't rush through traffic and have your vehicle maintained. Have a safe vehicle. So if you have a car or a quad or a motorbike, be sure that you have a good profile under your tires, right? You need it because it's super slippery. Those wet roads are slippery. Seriously, in those heavy rains that we face in our province here in October, November, the roads can look like rivers. I have a friend, she lives like in a small village close to my village, and there goes a road right up, and there is times with heavy rains, she does my hair, I cannot reach her house because the road looks like a river, and even the quad and four-wheel drive cannot get up there. That's a fact. You have to just accept it. And if you cannot accept this way of living, this is not the right area, then I just advise you to live in an area like in a big city, like in Santa Ana, where the roads are overall in better quality than at the peninsulas, right? Of Ossa and the peninsula de Nicoya and the southern parts where the rains can be pretty heavy. Also the Caribbean side, roads are not that perfect, right? So safety, when you go transporting yourself from A to B, have your vehicles checked, tires well-shaped, new tires, have your lights working, and also don't drive on the quad or on a motorbike when there's thunder. It's super dangerous. Accidents happen every year, not just because the thunder can hit you, but because trees can fall down. And you know, you live with the elements close to nature here, and rainy season in Costa Rica, don't see the rain, and that's like my final tip to close this video with. Don't see the rain as your enemy. Don't just say, "Bull, I hate the rain," and blah, 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 because the rain is also your best friend. Rainy season is the best season to plant stuff in your garden, on your land. It is the time when the earth sucks itself full with water, and seeds are just flourishing and sprouting, right? It's the season where the grass grows like this big, like in a week. It's crazy, but it's true. Rainy season is part of the circle of life in Costa Rica, of dry and wet season. And I personally enjoy the rainy season in Costa Rica. I am from the Netherlands, well known for biking, sunshine and beaches, but also a lot of rain. So when it rains, I just put a rain suit on here. I always have a good helmet and a good vehicle, good quad. Dirk loves to use the car, and you know, is dry, right, driving a car, but I love to drive my quad, and I have my rain suit on. I have my capuchon under my helmet with my visor, you know, and I don't know, I feel amazing driving through the rain, knowing that my vehicle will not, you know, knowing that my vehicle serves me, that I can take hills and stuff. But I'm always staying away from dangerous roads, and I respect Mother Nature. So this is my biggest three tips about rainy season in Costa Rica. And for more information about when exactly it is the wettest period in specific areas, Google it. There's lots of info to find about it. Overall, rainy season is from May until November. But at the Caribbean side, it's the opposite. That's the driest month. But Costa Rica has about 20 different climates, so it's worth it for you. That's my advice to you. Your task to do due diligence about the specific area you're planning to go to, and then look up when it's really wet there, the wettest predictions. And overall, Mother Nature has her own rules, and we have seen lots of rains in dry season and vice versa. So sometimes you just cannot plan things. Don't be angry when you plan your vacation in dry season and you have 3 days of rain. Sometimes it happens. So without further ado, I hope that you enjoyed my video. If you wonder what it is that I do to make my living here in Costa Rica, including in rainy season, how I enjoy living here when it's low season, and just, you know, live my life working from home for my own mortgage-free property close to Santa Teresa, go ahead and scroll below my video. There's a description with more information about my coaching programs, what I teach people globally online, if you're interested in learning how to build a business online the way that I have that done. Go ahead, be curious, click several links, get my book tips, connect with me, and I look forward to learning more about you. Leave your reply, your thumbs up, and of course, if you think others can benefit from my video, share it, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye for now, this was Muriel.